thumb injuries. This one's about the fracture and dislocation of the first carpal metacarpal joint, also known as the Bennet Fracture or even the Rolando Fracture. A fighter lands a looping punch on his opponent's head. The fighter's thumb is the first thing to make impact. While he is able to finish the fight, the base of the thumb is hurting. He had trouble gripping, and any pressure on the thumb hurt. As his adrenaline comes down, the pain gets worse. There's a lot of swelling, and bruising begins to form. Crap. He goes to the hospital and gets x-rays, and this is what they look like. This video is about a fairly common injury that occurs at the base of the thumb. It happened to arguably the best pound-to-pound fighter in the UFC in Alexander Volkanovski. It is technically a fracture and sometimes dislocation of the first carpal metacarpal joint, or first CMC joint. It has other names like the Bennet fracture, or if it's really bad, the Rolando fracture. And recognizing this injury and properly treating it is very important. The thumb is arguably the most important part of our hands. It has a huge influence on our ability to interact with the world. It is what separates us from much of the animal kingdom. Think of all the things we do with our thumbs, from writing, gripping, throwing. All of these things are possible because of our thumbs. And when we hurt our thumb, we know it because of how disabling it can be. There's a lot to talk about. Hopefully, by the end of the video, you will understand how important the thumb is, what a first CMC fracture dislocation is, how it happens, and how we as orthopedic surgeons treat it. I'm Dr. Lucius Pomerantz, board certified orthopedic surgeon and hand surgeon. So first we're gonna talk about the anatomy. The first CMC joint is very unique. It has to be. The motion that is required of our thumbs is very dependent on how this joint moves. It is called a saddle joint because, well, the two sides of the joint are shaped like saddles. One side is from the first metacarpal and the other is from a small carpal bone called the trapezium. This configuration allows for a ton of motion, but also can provide fairly good stability and energy transfer when necessary, like when pinching or having to grip. There are many described ligaments supporting the joint, but I will point out that the most important ones for this injury are at the back, the dorsal radial, and the front, the palmar oblique or beak ligaments. Now, the injury. This injury happens classically when force is put in line with the thumb when it is flexed. You can imagine how this might happen when throwing a punch or landing awkwardly on your hand when trying to grip something. Holding your thumb in your fist would only make this more likely as it flexes the first CMC joint more. The first metacarpal will break at its base and often the ligaments at the front, the beak ligament, stays intact, keeping the bone fragment in its normal position. However, the rest of the thumb keeps going and the ligaments at the back of the joint then tear, allowing the joint to dislocate. Side note, rarely the fracture does not occur and there is an isolated dislocation, but this is much less frequent. Since there are tendons attached and pulling the thumb bones, a classic deformity is created, with the first metacarpal being pulled back, down, and twisting. The classic fracture pattern has been called the Bennett's fracture. But if there is comminution or multiple bone pieces, it has been named the Rolando fracture. Some of you may be asking, so what? Well, with a fracture and dislocation of a joint, the usual smooth surfaces that glide past each other no longer are smooth or glide past each other. This creates grinding of the joint, and grinding in a joint eventually causes degenerative arthritis and pain. Additionally, the biomechanics of the joint are now altered, and the usual stability and energy transfer that is required to pinch and grip does not work as well. To prevent long-term pain and maintain strength, it is really important to get the first CMC joint smooth and stable. So the treatment. First things first, the diagnosis is made. X-rays are almost always the only thing that is needed to make the diagnosis. Unfortunately, with the ligaments torn and the bone broken into the joint, there is just too much instability to have adequate treatment with just a cast. Surgery is needed. Occasionally, there are exceptions. If the broken bone is just minimally displaced, like less than a millimeter, and if the ligaments in the back are not torn, one can avoid surgery. However, surgery is often needed. With surgery, there are lots of potential ways that the bones can be put back together and held there. The surgeon needs to counter the forces of the tendons tugging the bones by pulling and pushing and twisting the thumb and holding it all in the correct position. If the injury is caught early, then this can often be done just by putting pins through the skin. However, if there are many pieces or if the injury is treated late, then it will be necessary to surgically open the joint and put the bones back together and then hold it there. And this could be with pins, plates, screws, or a combination of things. As mentioned before, the goal is to get as smooth of a joint as possible and to restore stability to the joint. Healing. It usually takes 6 weeks for the tissues to heal. If pins are used, then they can be removed around the 6 week mark. If a plate and or screws are used, then they can usually stay there forever, so long as they are not causing any issues. Usually, use of the thumb is restricted until the bone is healed, and then it takes additional time to regain strength and range of motion. Often, a hand therapist will be necessary to help with this part of things. Usually, it takes at least 3 months to feel like the thumb function is getting back to normal, often longer. I usually say there can be some improvement in strength, range of motion, or pain for up to 1 year after surgery. The goal is always to return to normal function. I'm Dr. Lucius Pomerantz. Please share with your friends, like the channel, and subscribe. Thank you.